I don't know if everybody knows this, Chelsea, but the reason that you and Matt Cardona are together is because of Cody and Brandi.
Yeah. Cody and Brandi set us up. I mean, mostly, who knows what Cody did, but Brandi definitely planted all the seeds for me. I'll never forget when they came to Impact, and every day, probably like 3 days in a row, Brandi said something about Zack Ryder. So I was like, by the end of the tapings, I was like, what's going on? Something's going on. I feel like, is she trying to set me up? But I didn't really know what was going on. And I remember that I was already following Matt on Twitter. So I went on and unfollowed him.
Oh, you didn't want to date a wrestler.
Then when he looked, because he didn't follow me. So then when he looked, I wasn't following him. So I didn't look like a fangirl. But I totally followed him. I don't even think he knows that.
What? Now he knows.
Yeah.
So you didn't want to date a wrestler. Is that what this was?
No, I did not. And I'll tell you a funny story. I just got an email from Pat Kenny, who does NWA now. He worked at Impact with me when I first started for the first year, 2 years. And he just sent me this email and he said, I'm so happy for you and Matt, but funny, you told me you would never date a wrestler and I told you never say never. And I'm like, wow. Oh, yeah, I told all the girls. I told Maria Kanellis. I told Allie, I will never, ever date a wrestler. You will never catch me dating a wrestler. And then first wrestler I date.
What happened?
We fell madly in love. So bad.
I mean, Matt's pretty lovable.
I mean, it kind of has worked out with, you know, three cats and a dog and a house. I feel like we're doing well.
Yeah, I'd say so. So, I mean, did you immediately knew that you liked him after your first date?
I was pretty standoffish after our first date just because I was like, I'm not going to date a wrestler. But I will say he was persistent. He messaged me every day for a month straight until our second date. And then after the second date, I was like, oh, this is it. Like, I love him. That's that. And he was totally the same way.
So you guys waited a month between your first and second date?
Yeah, we had our first date at a terrible sushi restaurant. And then I had to go back to Canada and I had a bunch of like stunt doubling stuff I had to do and indie shows I had to do. So I was in Canada for a month. And so we had our first date in January and our second date like mid-February.
So Matt took a page out of your book, out of the persistence handbook, and just kept peppering you to see if this would work.
Yeah. Every morning I woke up to a text from him. So, I mean, persistence pays off.
Wow. And look at you guys now.
I know.
You'll get married one day.
Yeah. We'll just forever be engaged, but that's okay.
When did you find out that he was actually a giant child with everything that he collects?
I think probably the third date. On one of like our first dates, he said something about like a toy room or something. And I was like, I have to see this. Like, I couldn't imagine it. Uh-huh. And he said something about like, oh, you probably don't want to come over today because I have to build shelves for my toy room. And I was like, I'll help you build shelves. Like, I'm great at building IKEA furniture. So I'm like, I'll help you build them. I'm sure that that's actually probably what made him fall in love with me, because I'm sure everybody else was like, this is bizarre. But I like kind of took everything with a grain of salt. Now, granted, not everything was in this toy room. There was almost nothing in this toy room. This toy room has like exponentially blown up since I've been with him. So I didn't know that I was getting myself into like all of this.
At what point did you realize that that is what you signed up for?
Oh my God. Like after year one, I'm like, okay, there is Amazon package after Amazon package coming in. And like, he's going to his parents' house. He's picking up suitcases of stuff. And our garage just filled up more and more and more. And I was like, I've never seen anything like this. And now you should see it. We can't even walk through our garage. Our garage is like something out of Hoarders.
So what are you equally obsessed with?
Nothing. Everybody always asks me that. I'm telling you, everybody always asks me that. Yes, I have an obsession with bikinis, but like, I have a drawer. I don't have a room. You know what I mean? Like, and I'm not really your typical like girly girl. I don't like love shoes or purses or jewelry or anything like that. Like, I don't know. I'm such a neat freak that I love cleaning and giving away and donating. That's like my favorite thing to do. Pack up all of the stuff that I haven't worn in 6 months and donate it. And I just can't relate to Matt on this.
Well, bikinis are a pretty good obsession if you live in Florida.
I know. Well, that's like such a great obsession to have now.
I'm just laughing at this whole situation.
I know.
You're so good to Matt.
Oh my God. Honestly, like some of the things that I've unboxed and found at the front door, I mean, it's something else.
I think the thing that's most impressive about him, and now you have a chance to do this because you're not under contract, is basically really let your true personality out for the world to see. Matt loves action figures. Now he has a podcast about loving action figures that everyone can see. So I'm excited to see your YouTube channel kind of get rebirthed here.
I'm really excited just to figure out what it is that I want to show the world. You know, like I do show the world a lot through my Instagram, but I'm trying to figure out like what makes me and why do people want to come to my channel and why do people want to come to my Instagram? And I'm trying to figure that out by putting things out and seeing how people react. And that's what's kind of fun about this is just seeing what sticks.
Yeah. Well, I mean, obviously a lot of your fan base is wrestling, but not all of your interests are wrestling. So I feel like we're going to start to see a lot more of that.
I think that's the difference between myself and a lot of wrestlers is that I didn't grow up being a diehard fan. So my passion lies elsewhere.
Yeah.
I work and I when I'm at work, I focus on wrestling and I, you know, do what I have to do to entertain in that way. But there's so many other things in my life that I love that got me here to this crazy wrestling world.